coming into this round, all the talk had been how you've got to chip away at HRT. Well, Craig Lowndes and Marcus Ambrose on lap one took a sledgehammer to Mark Scaife off the start-finish line and are trying to hold him out now. This is lap eight of 39. Lowndes leads at Ambrose and Scaife 2 and 3.
Brake lockups from both the leading Fords. Saw Lowndes had a real barbecue. And then Marcus Ambrose, only seconds later, we hear HRT are setting up for a stop.
Whoops. There he goes.
He's done it again.
Through the inside, Mark Scaife through to turn two, but Ambrose puts the power down and shuts the door on him around a three.
Very, very difficult to pass around the outside there. Virtually impossible. So, Marcus did the right thing by covering the inside. He had a small lockup on the way in. Obviously, took him wide. Scaife thought it was an opportunity to grab him, but you can't do it from the outside. You'll have to find somewhere else to do that.
Boy, pressure's going to be on. 2.1 seconds between first and third. So Mark Scaife, Holden Racing Team, will be doing the sums. It all depends on really how well they've looked after their other tyres is going to determine how well they go in this final sector.
Yes, it's basically coming down, the third race and the final section of the race, in other words, the final half of tyre changes, so it's basically just down to how good your tyres are. It's a tyre race towards the end.
Tyre management throughout the day. You've got to be fast, but you've got to be a bit conservative and just try and save enough rubber in case you've got to sprint to the flag in the final race.
You've got to be consistent.
Yeah.
I think that's probably the answer to all this is. And this is where Tander's been coming all day. He's been coming up through the field. And whatever they've got in their car, it seems to be looking after the tyres very well.
Looking out the back of Mark Scaife's car, this battle group. Here comes Scaife. He's coming in for his compulsory tyre change. Have a listen to the team radio. Ambrose going as well, so they're going together.
He's a team versus team.
This will be thrilling stuff. Watch this battle amongst the wheel men. I think Lowndes has come in too.
Lowndes is in there as well.
All three of them together, so watch this. Pressure.
40Ks, mate. Nice and easy.
Remember, this pretty much determined what happened at Phillip Island in race one.
Lowndes does have 2 seconds up his sleeve. He had a lead in, so this will be interesting.
Mark Scaife making his way down pit lane. Keep in mind, from the moment they hit that marker on the entry to pit lane where they hit the 40 kilometre an hour speed limit, it's around about 45 seconds for them to trundle through pit lane, do the stop and get back out again. Craig Lowndes looks like he's going to get out in front of Mark Scaife here. Ambrose too. So Scaife retains third position.
Go, 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 go is the call. The two Fords get out in front of Mark Scaife.
He's still in a good round position.
Yeah, there he comes. So, positions restored.
That was slick, wasn't it? Very slick from all three teams. And remember that the Holden Racing Team has the last pit bay as well. So, those guys would have been seeing Mark Scaife's car sitting there before they had to leave pit lane.
Now, this is where the tyre strategy would really come into it. It depends. They've all put second-hand rubber on. Keep in mind, they've only got a choice of 10 tyres for the race weekend, so they've been swapping them around on the cars throughout the weekend. Now they come down to what they've got left, the best of what they've got left.
I wonder if Cole come on the radio now for the Kmart car in front of Ambrose to hold him up and let the HRT car go, because they are all under the same banner, the TWR banner. So I wonder if there'll be a telephone call soon to whoever's in that Kmart car.
Well, it'll be interesting. Here's our race leader. Leader because he's further back in the order, but in terms of the cars that have made their compulsory stops, Craig Lowndes is right up there. Well, it's an extraordinary record for Mark Scaife. He's won here 4 times in the V8 Supercar Championship, 3 times in succession. The last 3 years, he's heading for his record 4th in a row. Here's the fastest lap times you can see on the bottom of your screen.
Who's got the tyres hanging in at the end?
133 deep for Murphy, quickest one. Look at those times, they're very similar to what they were doing in race two, Wayne Gardner. So that was lap eight, so
the pace up a bit.
Yep. Interesting to see how these tyres are looking at the end of this one. 39 laps the total distance, they've got a long way to go, and they are on second-hand rubber. Here's Rick Kelly holding Young Lions car. Caterpillar Falcon of Simon Wills gets back into the action. Craig Lowndes.
Lowndes has done a very good job on his outlap on cold tyres. Yep. He actually made it, I think he's pulled about another second on them. So so he's very good on cold tyres, as we've seen at the start of the race. So he's got that added bonus, I guess, in pitting and getting out early.
He's back in 16th position at the moment. front of him, yet to make their compulsory tyre changes. So as they come in and pit, you see the 00 Motorsport Ford move up the order.
On board with a former three-time series champion, the V8 Supercars, with his sawn-off steering wheel, Craig Lowndes, the 27-year-old.
That steering wheel looks like it's something out of Star Trek, doesn't it?
Car 34, Garth Tander. You saw him in that leading quartet in the opening laps of the race. He comes in for his stop. Just trying to confirm whether Greg Murphy has already made his compulsory change.
Oh, Lowndes.
Another one. Locking up that inside front.
You know, if he keeps doing that, he's going to obviously get a flat spot on his tyre. He'll have to pit in again and get another front left. But he's obviously pushing very hard as he can now, to try and get a break on the rest.
Well, he hasn't won a round since Queensland 500 back in 2000, Craig Lowndes. That was when he was driving a Holden. It appears highly unlikely that he could lock up a round victory here, but he could certainly lock up a race three victory. This is only lap 12 of 39, and by my reckoning, on the overall standings for the day, I'm pretty sure that Marcus Ambrose has to put more than one or two positions in between him and Mark Scaife to put some pressure on him for the overall victory. Remember that Scaife has got two out of two victories as far as the races go here. The third one is certainly up for grabs, and it's a hell of a fight between Holden's number one man and Ambrose and Lowndes from the Ford fight. So Lowndes is there, Greg Murphy's in between them. Car number four is Marcus Ambrose, of course, and behind them is Mark Scaife. But car number 51, which is Murphy's car, is coming all the way up in there. He's pitted, and 15 is Todd Kelly.
Just some conjecture here with the timing. We're not quite sure. Like, they're showing some cars have made from their stops and some haven't. We're pretty sure that Murphy hasn't made his compulsory stop yet. That's how those other guys have ended up about at Murphy's track position.
I think what they might have done is made a mistake between that one and car 15, because they've now finally got Todd Kelly on the board. We saw him come in and out of pit lane, and pretty sure you're right about Greg Murphy, which is the reason why he's sandwiched up in there between our race leaders. Here's John Bauer, the Aussie male Ford Falcon, position number 17 at the moment. The quickest time, a 133.18, and he bumps himself up one position as he comes across the start-finish line.
Jason Bright, Todd Kelly, we just saw Kelly come in for a stop, David Bernard, Tony Longhurst, Jason Bhagwan and Max Wilson. Plenty of cars out there still to make their compulsory tyre change. Craig Lowndes back in 11th and moving up the order.
Sorry, Mark, I mentioned to you earlier at the start of the race, David Bernard, obviously he's my teammate, but they did made some changes, and he's now presently third. Obviously he hasn't pitted yet, but I know that the car is running strong. He's very happy with the changes. Hello, Kim. And which is a good sign. A good sign that he's coming through with the, obviously, yep, with the Caltex Havilland car.
Kim Jones there just waving to the cameras, team manager of the Aussie Male Ford team.
Just to let you know, too, that Oscar Fiorinotto has been on the radio to Craig Lowndes. There's been some conjecture about Greg Murphy. He has definitely pitted. So Oscar's been on the radio to Craig now saying, hey, Craig, it is for position. Greg Murphy is there with you.
Oh, it snuck in and out under everyone's guard, didn't he, Greg Murphy?
Yes.
Gee, they must have had a lightning pit stop. That must have been about 2 seconds to be able to get to there. It's incredible.
I don't quite understand that, anyway.
Position from the stop, mate. This is a race for position.
It is confirmation, just as Rusty said, that it is a race for position with Greg Murphy in that pack as well. So it's Lowndes, Murphy, Ambrose now has a sniff up the inside.
I guess, well done.
Oh, just
well
sneaks
done
up inside.
Contact.
Well done.
A little bit of
that
a bang
a
there. How
very
was that?
Good pass, that.
Had him, I think caught him napping.
I think caught him off guard there and didn't realise. And I think Marcus is going to catch Lowndes. As I keep saying earlier, is that I think the car's stiffer with Lowndes, and I think it'll work the tyres. Hey, he'll have the earlier pace, and Ambrose is, he's good at being consistent, he's good at looking after the tyres, and I think that he can catch him. And Scaife didn't make an impression on him as well. And at the moment, it looks like Ambrose is the mover in the pack.
Tander, fastest lap of the race.
Bit of a lock-up from Greg Murphy.
Super cheap autos. So Tander, 132.91. That's back into the quickest times we saw from Mark Scaife in race two. 132.99 for car one. Replay of this pass.
That's a good pass. I think Murph has got in there a bit. Yeah, he's gone in a bit wide. Got a lock, tried to catch it. Has he got it all under control? He's let Ambrose about the inside, and thank you very much from Marcus.
There comes Scaife bearing down on the other TWR Commodore. We're on board with Greg Murphy. Just goes to show the slightest little hiccup at this level of competition, and someone will take advantage. Looking at the back of the Kmart Commodore at Mark Scaife. These guys battling for 9th, 10th, 11th and 12th positions.
I wonder if there'll be a call on the radio now for Murph to let Scaife go up the inside, seeing they're under the same team. You know?
Car 35, Jason Barguana, the survivor from Phillip Island. Remarkable story earlier in the telecast, documenting the rebuild of that car in a very short space of time. It's amazing Barguana is even here.
I think that accident showed really just how strong these cars are and what a good safety solid they're sitting in. And obviously it's a very dangerous sport, but there's a pretty good element of safety now in it, built in obviously with equipment and particularly the strength of those cars and roll cages.
Some of these positions, so those yellow boxes showing how many positions they've climbed up the field. They can be a little bit deceptive when these pit stops are taking place, because you find yourself climbing up the order as a result of people pitting. This is on board. Mark Scaife applying more pressure to Greg Murphy in the Kmart Commodore.
Here he goes. I thought he'd try here on brakes. Yep. I was just about to say, I bet he goes to the inside here. And to me, that looked like, I'll move over and let you through. I think there might have been a call on the telephone booth.
You're convinced, aren't you?
I'm convinced. They drive for the same team, different colours, but, you know, and that's how teams should work. They should work together like that, and I'm sure that was what that was all about.
David Bernard comes in for his compulsory stop. They've left him out much longer than Marcus Ambrose. Lap 16 of 39.
Looking good, Dave. We're up in sixth place. If you count the pit stops as well, head down when you go out.
Giving you some encouragement there, Campbell Little on the headsets.
Yeah, Campbell's a good guy, and he runs a good operation there. And I think Dave is doing a good job this week. It was just unfortunate they had a wheel roll away in the past pit stop, and I can see it's not happening this time. And the Caltex 17 team are getting the side changes together, and away he goes. That was a good stop. So I'm sure we'll see him make some places up in this next stint.
You also saw Brad Jones in car number 21, the Aussie male Ford Falcon, in there for his pit stop as well. That's Cameron McLean. He's in front of Mark Scaife at the moment on the track. But this man, Tony Longhurst, currently has the race position, but he's yet to pit. So too is Max Wilson and Larry Perkins. Bernard's gone in, but Craig Lowndes will be our race leader. But it all gets sorted out. McLean's there, Ambrose and Scaife and Murphy. We're in for a hell of a battle. This is race 3 of the V8 Supercars. You're at Eastern Creek in Sydney.